off. I remember when they told me I wouldn't be famous. Now my dream and reality is simultaneous. And work your own way to the top. If they put you on the pedestal, they can take you off. And there's a higher level than the top. You gotta make more, don't make do with what you got. Check, so go and get it in, sunny. Not everybody gets a second chance at getting money.
I just knew the power in these young women and just how faithful they've been to each other, and it's a special team, and it's just so great to see. I talk about always reaping what you sow, and I think that they did that today, and they were just phenomenal on the field as a unit.
I feel like it's a storybook end to my career for the Atlantic 10. I mean, to be used as kind of like a secret weapon is kind of an honor. And to say that I scored the game-winning goal in our championship game is something I'll never forget and something I'll always have with me. And I couldn't have done it without my teammates.
Emily, she's such a character. You know, she's back there. She defends so well. And it's just ironic that her last two games where she had to score to stay on and had to win, that she did. She just found a way of putting it in the net, which is incredible.
I think that if I can remember Emily's face and how excited she was both days scoring those goals, nothing will make me happier. She was so excited, and nothing feels greater than seeing her feel that glory and getting that for the team. We made a great stand. Two shutouts in the conference tournament is outstanding, and the whole defensive unit, everyone who played, just we were deny all day, both games. So it was great.
Before the game, we talked about it just like we did yesterday, and we decided that we were going to keep them right out of our circle because they can't get in the circle, they can't score. And I think altogether our defensive unit was so united and so behind each other.
The past 2 days, our team really played together, and we completely dominated the other teams with our attack, and our defensive unit was so strong, and it was just an entire team effort that was absolutely phenomenal.
We came out here knowing that we had the talent, we had the skill, and all we had to do was execute. And the whole weekend we were just talking execution, and today we really did do a great job of playing Richmond hockey.
Cannot describe how excited I am right now. We've worked so hard all season since we first came for preseason in August, and you know, the seniors have led us this whole season, and it's been great to be a part of this whole team.
I feel so blessed to have been a captain on an amazing team like this, filled with wonderful girls and an amazing coaching staff, and I'm just so proud of each and every one of them and so blessed to be a part of this team.
This team has been so honest. They've just been, I think, just like walk the narrow path in every way, in just things that we do in our culture, just making sacrifices, and I'm just so thankful. We're so blessed.
It has always been my dream to go back and play in California and have my family there, entire family, to support me, and it is truly a dream come true, and I feel so blessed and so thankful.
She always wanted to go home to the West Coast, and she always wanted to play there, and just to get to go there, and all the girls are so excited. It's just going to be a great trip.
You know, Caitlin is just so faithful, and is just such a leader, a captain, and just a warrior. And so to be able to bring her back home is just as, you know, I don't have words for it. I'm just obviously just, you know, so thankful and elated.
It's really cool for Caitlin. She's really excited about it. We all are pumped. I think it's another chance for us to just come and show this country who we are. You made me who I am.